Hello. Start doing more teaching videos, how-to videos for glass work. And in stained glass and infused glass, a lot of people use grinders. By the way, believe it or not, there's a lot of people who don't use a grinder. And the lead people that do stained glass, a lot of them don't use a grinder because the lead covers it up. And whatever extra pieces are on, they'll use grozers or nippers to break the pieces of glass off. There's a couple kind of grinders that's out there, and I have them both for this particular application. I do stained glass and fused glass. This is called a grinder, and they're little drums. You can get different bits for these type of grinders. It looks like a little drum. This is a bad one. This is where the frit has left the I didn't report it in other words, get my free one within a year. I go through so many of these things, it doesn't matter. This is called a ripple bit. I've explained that on a video in the past. Perhaps when I do more grinder videos, I'll introduce the reason why. Here's a jeweler's bit. They put a groove in there so that people can take their dichroic cabochons and such and wire wrap them. It cuts a little groove into the side. When you put it on here, you don't put it on top of there like that, but you get the idea. You put it on the shaft, you wrench it down with a little Allen head wrench. These are called drums, little drum grinder bits, versus this type of grinder. It's called a disc grinder, and this takes a 6-inch flat disc. I love this grinder. I've been doing stained glass over 15 years. This is the only disc grinder that I will advocate anybody to buy. I haven't tried currently within the last couple years newer models. I only endorse the Glastar because I've used it for that long, and I've used the others where they fall far short. The quality of the disc is not even in the make-believe pretend close area, and neither is the quality of the grinder. I've had grinders go out in 3 months, and I use them hard, so if it only lasts 3 months, it ain't worth a darn. And these grinders here have a 5-year warranty, I believe, on them, the Glastars. And you can even order an extra motor, which I did. So anyway, I'll do the disc grinder in another video. This grinder is about this drum grinder, and I'm going to grind a piece of glass for you so you can see what it's about. By the way, something you want to do is this grinder requires water. Well, actually, all grinders do. And I use one of these little bottles. It's a perfect bottle. You recognize it as hazelnut cream for your coffee. Makes an ideal bottle, especially if you keep the lid on it from evaporation and you use this lid. It can be ideal. I just took it out for this video here, and you pour a little bit of water in there. And what you want to do is you want to pour it up to the top of these squares. Not to the top of the squares, let me rephrase that, to the bottom of the square so that you can at least see some water, because I got mine on a foot switch, which is the ultimate. What it does is the water comes up through this sponge and wets the drum. As you can kind of see, I don't know if you can see clearly, the water splashing my finger. So you also want a face shield, and I'm not sure this face shield came with this grinder. This is the Glastar All-Star. It's the largest of them. If you don't have a foot switch, you gotta use the on and off switch, which eventually wears thin and wears out. You get a lot of years out of a switch, but I prefer always leaving it on and going to foot switch. It's the best. And it saves on the switch on your grinder. My switch sounds new because it doesn't get used ever, other than leave it on and the foot switch takes over. So I got a little splash guard here around it so it doesn't get all over the place. Because of the water that's in this grinder, it has a messy effect. And occasionally you have to clean this lens off. I cut mine out of glass. This is the, you can buy these little risers for eye shields anywhere through your local glass, stained glass company, or distributor or eBay or what have you. And then I cut a piece of glass. And that works for me. So I'm going to take the glass off and show you that there's another thing about this grinder that you have to keep up with. In fact, all grinders, what happens is when you grind the glass, microscopic particles and little small particles accumulate and it looks like a paste. And I'm just using a nylon paint scraper. And this is what it's going to look like. This spooge looking stuff is what's in the bottom of all grinders. And depending on how much you use your grinder every day or week, if you're a professional or, well, it has nothing to do if you're a professional or not, because some professionals only make a window every now and then, and some every day. So if you're using this grinder every day, you're going to accumulate this kind of junk in the water. And I'm not going to clean it out right now, so I'd have bounced the video around, but you get the idea. You need to clean this out. Of course, when you take out this paste, this spooge junk, it lowers the water level. So you're going to need to fill the water level back up to some degree. I'm going to grind a piece of glass, just in the idea of it, bouncing my camera around here right now so I can locate it. Sorry about that. But if I stop the camera, then it'll start a new film. And what you're going to do, you can raise and lower this grinder bit. Depending on how much use is out left out of it, you can raise and lower the bit. And I'll just basically show you. Just following the outline. Now you're not going to get scratched by this piece of glass. And the idea behind grinding that is to make it consistently perpendicular so that it either you're going to use lead or you're going to use copper foil. You'll notice that this piece has a white frosty to it once the water evaporates, and now it's perfectly ready to copper foil. If you don't, and it's dark like this over here is showing, right here in this area, then obviously your copper foil is not going to stick because there's still moisture in the glass. So you want to wait till it has that white frosty look, and then you're ready to go. If you use Noxema and hand cream and lotions and stuff, you do not want to rub this because the oil off of your nose, off of your french fries, I'm being funny, but anytime you go eat, you want to wash your hands because the oil on your hamburger bun and what have you will cause your foil not to stick to your glass. So just wash your hands before you go to work. Sounds kind of funny because right now don't seem like this would make any difference, but it will. You'll find it frustrating if your copper foil is not sticking, and one of the reasons could be because you have oil on your hands from hand cream, Jergens, anything like that. We'll disallow you to for your copper foil to stick. Anyway, that's kind of the basis about this type of grinder. I like Wizard, but I don't like the new design of the, or I should say Inland grinders. I don't like the new design of the Inland Wizard. So I went to All-Star. And I like the All-Star. Their bits are expensive, but you get what you pay for. They're the highest quality, I believe, for a grinder that's available to the public on just a regular stock basis. I'm sure there's better grinders out there. I've never heard of them. This grinder here is about $225, and the disc grinder runs about $350. They're high-quality machines. I believe they both have five-year warranties. I don't sell these things, so I'm not some salesman, but I'm just spouting off what I know about these after 15 years, over 2,500 stained glass creations. Check it out. And the sides you need to keep clean eventually with CLR or whatever that calcium stuff is. You need to clean them up. I don't do mine as often as I probably should, but oh well. I'll get back to it eventually and clean these up. So thanks for watching my video, and the next video will be on the disc grinder and the virtues of why you want one. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.